We wish him all the best. He's a friend and much respect.
This is every update that you need to know in the NBA.
ESPN lost the best basketball insider in the media on Wednesday. Adrian Wojnarowski announced that he is leaving ESPN after 7 years with the company.
He's the best in the business. He's the best in the business. Make no mistake about it. Nobody's more well-connected. Nobody's more respected. And to be around him and to just have to be able to touch on a wealth of knowledge that he's had in all of his years covering the league, the contacts that he has, the inside information that he's had, he's led this place for quite a long time.
Woj will turn his attention to his alma mater, St. Bonaventure, where he has agreed to become general manager of the school's basketball program. This is a very sad day for all NBA fans who knew that Woj bombs were the first to report any big NBA trade or anything going on ever. NBA fans are anxiously waiting the release of the upcoming Starting Five documentary series on Netflix, and they received a first taste on Tuesday. This trailer actually looks really good.
Basketball is a beautiful sport. We love going out there playing in front of the fans.
Come on, man! I got kids. I got a family.
Everyone thinks our dad is the legend of basketball, but he's just like a normal person.
It's showtime.
I don't know if there's many leagues that have bigger stars than the NBA.
I'm Jason Tatum.
Jimmy Butler.
Domantas Sabonis.
Anthony Edwards.
LeBron James.
Show me how you shine. Show me how you shine. Yeah.
Ready? The Cavs officially signed wing Isaac Okoro to a 3-year, $38 million contract on Tuesday. $33 million of Okoro's new contract is fully guaranteed, but is this man worth all of that money?
Cavaliers open up 3 of 5 from the field. Early offense. Garland rims out on a three. Allen couldn't grab. Mobley does. Open look. Okoro.
And I like the strategy here early from Cleveland.
And it's rebounded by Tatum. Send it over to Stephanie.
Guys, I spoke with Jaylen Brown before the game about winning player of the week, and I gotta tell you, he wasn't impressed.
Jason Tatum is 5 for 5 from deep. 7 of 8 overall from the floor. 3 of 4 at the line. Game high 22. Garland to the corner. Okoro.
The Memphis Grizzlies did not make any NBA offseason moves. Believing in the roster that they already have, the Grizzlies will hope for better injury fortune this season than they had last year. But let's be honest, Ja Morant is not enough to carry an entire offense to an NBA championship, so rumors are growing of a trade for Brandon Ingram.
Rising, waits for the pick. Good luck.
Good patience.
Good luck.
That's good patience. Just recognizing.
Mitchell. Blocked from behind. It'll belong to the Pels offense. Good job by Brandon right on top of the basketball. Jaylen Brown off the pick. Nice and trying to hold his ground and take it away. Najee comes up with it. Najee has Brandon if he wants him.
Good bounce in his step.
He's going up against Wembanyama. And goes right by him. Hammers it home.
That bounce right there.
They've got 25 and 14 to the 25 in the paint. Wanted to go to Larry. Great pass to get it down low and inside.
You want to see if he has the legs needed on those long shots.
Mizumu. Choked off. Taken away. Brandon's got it. Brandon up against DeMar.
In a recent article, Bleacher Report's Grant Hughes proposed a hypothetical deal that sends New Orleans Pelicans star Brandon Ingram to Memphis. The Grizzlies would receive Brandon Ingram, and the Pelicans would receive Marcus Smart, Brandon Clark, a 2025 first-round pick, and a 2026 second-round pick. Now that today's updates are over, it's time for the Chosen Challenge. Who led the NBA in steals per game last season? My first follower that answers correctly will be crowned the new Chosen King in my next video.